about this week?
We are learning that when we're not truthful, we lose trust.
Ooh, yeah, that's super important too. Have you ever lost trust with someone?
Yeah, my agent, Daryl.
Oh no, what happened?
Oh, okay. So he got me this job, like working on a TV show with a really super famous actress.
Really? Who was it?
You.
Aw, thanks. Does Daryl think I'm famous?
I'm your biggest fan, Lizzie.
Oh, Daryl, that is just the sweetest thing ever. And I'm so sorry that you lost your trust in Daryl, Jerry. But it sounds like that was just a misunderstanding. I think we'll be talking more about times when we might be tempted to tell a lie or do something dishonest, which is not good. But more on that later. Let's welcome our VIPs.
Still gotta get paid, Lizzie.
Okay.
Sometimes you take a job for the clout.
Okay.
Sometimes you take jobs because you gotta eat.
Okay. We'll talk about that later. Okay. Now we're gonna welcome our VIPs.
Hey, VIPs. If you're here for the very first time, we're gonna give you some instructions near the end of our time together, okay?
And our special shout out today is for Scarlett from Brooklyn, New York.
What's up, Scarlett? Yeah, well, thank you so much for coming to Motion. All right, Liz, are you ready for a quiz on New York?
Nope.
Great, here we go.
Okay. Oh, boy.
It's time for the Liz quiz.
Not the Liz quiz.
Oh, this one's
going to
be.
Where are our lights? Oh.
You said that as the, give me a moment.
Okay.
I tried to hit the remote.
It's fine, technical difficulty.
Okay,
it's
all right.
Fine.
I'm going to make this question doubly hard just because you interrupted me.
I'm sorry.
Okay. Here we go. Time for the hard question. Okay. The state of New York produces a lot of two specific foods. Yes. Only one other state in the country produces more of these two foods. What are they? And Coney hot dogs is not one of them.
Oh, man. Okay, yeah, that was going to be my first guess. Sorry.
I know what you're thinking.
Okay.
Here
probably
we go.
Cheesecake, right? That's not, you know.
All right.
Never mind. Okay.
You're narrowing it down. All right, here we go. Here's your options. Okay. Pears and walnuts.
Okay, pears and walnuts. Interesting. Okay.
Plums and brown sugar.
What? These are so random.
Yes. Cherries and ketchup.
What?
Or apples and maple syrup.
What? Okay, well, I do know that they call New York the Big Apple. So, and I know maple syrup, that's like Canada's pretty famous for maple syrup, right? New York is up there.
I'm not giving you hints.
Right?
You're fishing.
Okay.
Stop fishing.
I'm gonna
go. Just answer the question.
Final answer, locking it in. Apples and maple syrup. Yes! I got it right.
Boo.
I'm so happy. Wow. All right. Well, it looks like since I got it right, I get a treat later. So you guys will get to see what I get finally, not having to do a challenge. I'm so excited.
That one last week was so gross.
No, yeah, I would not do it. I don't want that again. No, okay. So let's go ahead and worship now. Remember, Emotion, this month when we worship, I want you to think about how worship is one of the best ways we can show God how thankful we are for everything he's done for us. If you had a great day yesterday, or if your grandparents are coming to visit, or even if you're just enjoying the weather today, all of those things we can thank God for. So while we get up on our feet, I want you to think about something good God has done for you and use this time of singing and dancing to tell him thank you.
Hey, Motion, we're so excited you're here to praise the Lord. Praising God reminds us he's there so we never have to feel alone. James 4:8 says, when you draw near to God, he will draw near to you. So as we sing today, let's thank God for always being close to us and for loving us no matter what. Come on, stand to your feet. Let's get ready to sing.
Forget that the fire is how I'm refined. I try to keep pressing on with hope tight. But sometimes I fall, I've gone through it all. I know you'll be by my side. There's no guarantee in this life. Yeah, trouble's a matter of time. But you're in control, that's how I know. You're everything gonna be okay.
faith has growing pains. You're the light, leading me on through the depths of the night. You're the prize, waiting for me at the end of this life. So I try to keep pressing on with hope tight. But sometimes I fall, got through it all. I know you'll be by my side. There's no guarantee in this life. Your trouble's a matter of time, but you're in control. That's how I know. You're everything gonna be okay. It won't always be this way. And the worst way it hurts, won't be afraid. I know that sometimes faith has growing pains. Yeah, sometimes faith has growing pains. Sometimes faith has growing pains. Yeah, there's no gain without the pain. And sometimes faith has growing pains. Everything gonna be okay. It won't always be this way. Sometimes faith has growing pains. Oh, everything gonna be okay. This will all make sense.
for worshiping with me, Motion. Worship is such a great way to show love and gratitude to God. Let's hop into the Story Lab to see what they have to say about integrity today.
This week, we're talking about integrity.
And we'll meet a man who learned that lying can really get under your skin.
Let's go.
Hey, I'm Skylar.
And I'm Sebastian.
And today, we're talking about integrity.
Which is choosing to be truthful in whatever you say and do.
Hey, Sebastian, what you doing? Selling some toys?
Nope. I'm figuring out what car I want when I'm older.
Ooh, I want a red car.
There's more to a car than just the color.
Trust me, I'm ahead of you there.
I doubt it.
Maybe we should put our car knowledge to the test.
So, you want to compete with me to see who knows more about cars?
Is your fuel pressure regulator busted? Because it sounds like you're stalling.
Oh, it's on. Whoa, what is this?
We've got to guess what kind of vehicle is in the picture.
Piece of cake. Minivan.
Looks more like a bus.
But it's not yellow, so...
I say school bus.
Huh? No way. This one's mine.
Looks a little dirty.
Dump truck? Wait, no! Garbage truck! Yes!
For the tiebreaker.
Wait, I know what this one is.
That's a punch
PW
buggy!
Bug.
Was that necessary? We're still tied.
Well, I think we need to suit up and
settle this on the track.
Let's make it. You can make the car from a lot of things. For this project, you'll need a car body, axles, wheels.
And of course,
tape.
Always.
And I got this kit I want to use. So the last thing we need is fuel.
Fuel?
Sure, a car can't run without fuel. But for this project, the fuel will be the air we put into these balloons. First, attach the straws to the bottom of your car. Then, slide in your axles. This is what you'll attach your wheels to.
Now the wheels?
You got it.
And if you need to poke holes in the wheels, you'll need a grown-up to do that.
That's right. Now, attach the balloon to the plastic tube. Make sure it's good and tight so no air will leak. Finally.
Let me guess. You attach the balloon to the car.
You are correct. And that's it. Now you have a balloon-powered car. Guess there's just one thing left to do.
What's that? Oh, yeah.
Racers, start your engines!
Hey, get your wheels all the way to the back.
My fault.
Cheater.
Whoa,
oh,
that's loud.
Really loud.
That's like a fire alarm.
Three,
two, one.
Wait, it's still going? Yes!
I think it's time for a rematch. I mean...
No. It's time for...
The story before the story.
Today, we're in the 12th book of the Bible, 2 Kings. This tells the story of God's people while they were ruled by kings.
Here, we also meet a man called Naaman, who's the commander of the armies of a foreign nation, Syria. But Naaman became very sick with a skin disease, and no one could help him.
A servant girl from Israel who knew the one true God said that a prophet of God named Elisha could help Naaman.
So Naaman made the long journey to Israel and eventually ended up at the home of Elisha. And that's where our story starts.
Take it away.
Hey everyone, I'm Jen. When Naaman contracted a skin disease, he became an outcast, someone people avoided. He was so desperate that he traveled to an enemy nation looking for help. And God used the prophet Elisha to heal Naaman by telling him to dip 7 times in the murky Jordan River.
I'm well!
Naaman immediately traveled back to the home of Elisha.
I now know there is no God in all the earth except in Israel. Now please, accept a gift from me.
Naaman offered Elisha money as a way of saying thank you. But Elisha wasn't about to take a reward for something God had done.
As surely as the Lord lives, I won't accept anything.
So Naaman kept his money and rode off in his chariot, heading back home to Syria. Enter Gehazi. Gehazi was Elijah's servant. When Naaman offered silver, you can imagine how excited Gehazi was. All that money coming into the household, he might have been dreaming about what he could buy. But then Elijah said, no. Wait, what?
My master Elisha refused to take Naaman's gift, but why should I miss out?
So Gehazi ran after Naaman's chariot. When he saw Gehazi, Naaman stopped the chariot and hopped out, concerned.
Is everything okay?
Everything's all right. My master has sent me.
Lie number one.
My master said, two young men just came to me, so please give me 75 pounds of silver and two changes of clothes for them.
Well, Naaman was so happy to help that he gave Gehazi the clothes and twice the amount of silver he asked for. Sneaky mission accomplished, right? Wrong. Because after stashing the silver and clothes, Gehazi went back to Elijah.
Where have you been, Gehazi?
I didn't go anywhere.
Lie number two. And that's when Elijah dropped a truth bomb.
Gehazi, God showed me how you chased down Naaman and lied to him. And now you're lying to me as well. Because of that, you will have the same skin disease that Naaman had.
And sure enough, instead of getting to enjoy silver and fine clothes, Gehazi himself ended up with leprosy. The end.
Well, that story sure took a turn.
No kidding.
Gehazi started with one lie.
And then he had to tell more lies to cover up the first lie.
Telling the truth can be hard sometimes, but it's still easier than dealing with the problems that lying creates.
So, what's our part in the story?
Well, integrity is choosing to be truthful in whatever you say and do. That means telling the truth, the whole truth, even when it's hard.
Like when your mom asked you if you brushed your teeth.
Or when you have to admit to your teacher you didn't do your homework.
Or when it would be so easy to stretch the truth just to get someone to like you.
If you don't tell the truth, you might get by for a short while. But eventually, the person you lied to will discover the truth.
And they won't want to trust you anymore.
Jesus is a perfect example of living truthfully in everything he said and did. He always spoke the truth, even when it was hard.
And he always did it in a loving way.
With God's help, we can follow Jesus, choosing to be truthful in all we say and do.
I think you got it. Peace!
So here's the thing. When you're not truthful, you lose trust.
Just like Gehazi.
His story got pretty out of control.
You think my balloon car will get out of control if I use this?
Whoa! Thanks for joining us in the Story Lab. See you next time.
Oh, I kind of forgot to attach my car.
Well, flying cars shouldn't be invented yet.
So let me get this straight. Naaman tried to pay Elisha for healing him, but Elisha said not to worry about it. Then Elisha's servant chased Naaman down and lied, saying that Elisha did want some money for healing him. What? Wow, it's no wonder Elisha lost trust in his servant. It's so important that we're truthful, Motion, because trust is hard to get back once we lose it. I think we ought to talk about this some more.
Thank you. What's up, Motion? It's time for this week's Memory Verse Challenge. We're going to show you how to play what I called Speed Say. Do you remember which verse we're learning this month? It's Proverbs 10:9, and it says this: whoever walks in integrity walks securely, but whoever takes crooked paths will be found out. This verse tells us that if we live with integrity, choosing to be truthful in whatever we say and do, that we will be secure. But if we don't live with integrity, others will find out that we aren't truthful, and they won't put any trust in us.
Here's how Speed Say works. We'll have the verse here in front of us, and we'll see how many times we can say it in only 30 seconds. The more we say a verse, the better we can remember it when we're not looking at it.
We've already got the verse marked in our Bible. So now we're going to set up a phone, which is mine right here, or any timer that you may have with you, here for a 30-second countdown. We'll see who can say it the most times.
All right, here is our first round of Speed Say. I'm gonna go first, you time me. Ready? Okay. Well, tell me when to go, tell me
on
when
your mark, get set, go.
Whoever walks in integrity walks securely, but whoever takes crooked paths will be found out. Whoever walks in integrity walks securely, but whoever takes crooked paths will be found out. Whoever walks in integrity walks securely, but whoever takes crooked paths will be found out. Whoever walks in integrity walks securely, but whoever takes crooked paths will be found out. Whoever walks in integrity walks securely, but whoever takes crooked paths will be found out. Whoever walks in integrity walks securely, but whoever takes crooked paths will be found out. Whoever walks with integrity,
Time! Oh, snap! Whoa!
that my time was up. That's hard. But I feel like I'm like getting it in my spirit. I get it.
I feel it.
It's just hard to say it.
Whoever walks.
All right, your turn.
Okay.
I need a timer, swapsies. Okay. I'll tell you when to go.
Okay.
Ready, set, go.
Whoever walks in integrity walks securely, but whoever takes crooked paths will be found out. Whoever walks in integrity walks securely, but whoever takes crooked paths will be found out. Whoever walks in integrity walks securely, but whoever takes crooked paths will be found out. Whoever walks in integrity walks securely, but whoever takes crooked paths will be found out. Whoever walks integrity walks securely, but whoever takes crooked paths will be found out.
Done!
Dang. Snap! Well, I think we did pretty good, but I bet you can do way better, Motion. If you don't have a watch like me or a phone or something you can use to time yourself, ask a parent or a trusted adult to time you while you read the verse out loud as many times as you can.
Try it each day this week. Trust me, practicing it, saying it fast will really help you remember it. And remembering it will help you remember to have integrity in everything you do.
That's right. Now we should go check out Game Time.
Let's do it.
What's up, Motion? I'm Tori.
I'm Carlos.
And I'm Katya.
And today, we got a challenge.
And don't try this at home.
What's a vest for?
This is an option.
I don't know how to
talk. Can you scan this?
Speed $15.
$30.
Oh wait, can you scan my thing? I know you were with me when I said sale, but what if it's not on sale?
$5.
What if I got a speaker?
I have expensive.
What? I could.
This might be like an ore.
Yes.
Like my initial game plan was to put a few of these together and sit on it. Oh! I'm getting distracted.
It was cool. I got distracted.
I need two of these. I have an idea. If I sit on this and kind of ski my way through.
Are you going to go down your belly or on your knees or on your back?
Oh my gosh, I didn't even think about going on my belly. That might be smooth.
You need some elbow pads up your ass.
My elbows are precious.
Okay, if you think I'm gonna win, I need you to cheer me on when I'm going. I need your cheers if you believe in me.
If y'all think that I'm gonna win, go and cheer for me.
Okay, if you think that I'm gonna win, everybody start cheering, let's go, Tori! Let's go, Tori! Because I'm gonna win.
So I have a little laundry cart right here. I'm gonna sit in it. I fit perfectly. I'm gonna tape this skateboard on the bottom with that duct tape. And then I have coloring pencils at my desk, so I'm gonna color a little bit of something. I have a little license plate, which is like, Jesus loves me, and the power of his love is gonna make me win.
Oh.
Okay, I gotta find a cheaper skateboard, y'all, because I don't got money for this. It's only $14.96. Done and done. Okay, so here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna get rid of this. I'm gonna take the skateboard. Okay, I'm gonna take this thing.
Y'all got six.
I'm gonna duct tape as much as I can. I'm gonna sit in it. I'm gonna use this as a steering wheel. Go down the hill like that. And I gotta go make it cute. I got 6 minutes. Let's go.
I got an idea.
That is cheating.
Why?
Because you're using something that's already created.
So are you using a skateboard?
This is not a real horse. This is not gonna help me. If I put weights on their cars, then it'll go slower.
You just go by and toss them in their car.
Why am I going so slow? Why do I feel so heavy? This is why. Do I have enough in my budget?
Yeah, we'll put it in.
Move! Here's my plan. This is for safety. But my plan is to use this, put it on my belly. Then I lay down. As I'm on my belly, I have these to like,
you need duct tape?
I don't know.
How are you gonna tape it to your belly?
Well, maybe they'll let me, they have it. Maybe they'll let me borrow it. They're not gonna use all of it. I ski, this helps me go. And then if they're in my way.
Ready.
It's 30, they lied to me a little bit.
You don't gotta know.
I know, I'm a little nervous now.
This is over, buddy. Yo, look. The string?
There's no way.
This doesn't have a tag.
Motion, it's been great learning about integrity with you today. Don't forget, you can be truthful with your whole life. It's almost time for us to go, but VIPs, there's something special we need to tell you about. If today was your first time with us, ask an adult in your house to look down below this video. There's a link down there so they can send us some info about you. Then I can reach back out and say hi. Now let's pray together. Motion, did you know that when we can pray for anyone? Mm-hmm. We can pray for ourselves, for our friends, for our family, or even for people we don't know at all. No matter who we pray for, God wants us to spend time talking to him. Why don't you give it a try this week and pray for some other people? Now, let's pray together. God, thank you for teaching us about integrity. Help us to be truthful so that we won't lose trust. In Jesus' name, everybody said, amen. Great job. Thanks for hanging out with me today, everybody. Now for the crazy part. Let's see what kind of snack Jerry has planned for me today. Woo!
All right, Liz, it's time for your gross food. Do you eat a lot of like very tiny eggs?
What,
often?
Tiny eggs?
Very tiny eggs.
I mean, I eat like regular eggs, like people do like scrambled eggs or like an omelet or something, but
no, you're thinking too
tiny?
Big.
Wait.
Okay. Go ahead and reach in front of you.
Okay.
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 There's like a petri dish.
Wait. Oh, I'm feeling something. Okay.
Yep. Okay.
Hold on. Do I hold it up?
I would say just toss it down the old pipe.
Oh, wait, the whole thing?
Yeah.
What is it? Wait.
You are going to tell me.
I'm so nervous. Is this like, was it or is it an animal?
It was.
What? No, seriously? Oh, I'm so nervous.
I think.
Was it really?
Maybe afterwards I'll fact check.
Is it like
possibly.
A bug or something?
Nope.
Okay.
Oh, not that I can tell you.
It feels like a bug, Jerry. It feels like a bug. Yeah. Okay. Hold on. Oh, I'm so nervous.
Yeah, if you go by the movies, I think Timothy Chalamet would tell you that they came from a far off land.
What?
That's your only hint.
So it's a bug from a far off land? It
possibly.
Just keeps getting worse. Okay, I'm so nervous. Okay.
Just so you know, that was a Willy Wonka reference.
Okay, that was a good one. Okay, here we go. Ready? It's fine. Oh.
Thoughts?
Oh. Okay. The texture is that of a bug. But.
Yes.
The flavor is like, it's like sour.
Okay.
It almost like has like a, almost like a Nerds kind of, or like a Sour Patch, but not quite. It's thicker than a Sour Patch.
Yeah.
Can I
go ahead and take off the eye mask. Yeah.
Let me see. Here we go.
It's actually a Nerd Rope.
What?
Yeah. It's kind of like, yeah.
What? That's so cool. Okay. No, here's the thing. This actually, it feels like a bug.
It does.
Like that freaked me out.
I know. I tried to freak you out first by telling you it was tiny
terrifying.
Eggs.
Oh boy. Yeah. Tiny eggs. Well, it's actually kind of good though. I like it a lot. So, but do you want to try? Are you sure? Jerry, you throw up about a lot of stuff. Please don't throw up. Don't throw up. Here we go. No. Okay, you're supposed to chew it, not swallow it. It's okay. You're good.
Thank you.
Okay. Well.
You saved my life.
Okay. It's not that dramatic, but okay. Wow. Well, this is actually a really good one. I'm excited. I think I'm going to get some more right and then have some more treats that I get.
You will learn that oftentimes my tricks and treats stay, they're kind of the same thing.
They're kind of similar.
Yeah.
I don't like that. I don't like that at all. All right, friends. Well, make sure you come back next week to see what crazy things we're going to be doing. Bye.
John.
Yeah.
Where's my chair?
Oh, yeah, sorry. Yeah, come around here. I want to show you something cool.
All right. Whoa.
Right? I thought our old chairs were getting pretty boring, so I thought we deserved some cool ones.
Cool ones?
Yeah, because we're cool.
Right, we're cool.
Yeah, we're cool.
We are cool.
And we deserve cool chairs.
That make us look cool.
Sit in your cool chair, my man.
All right.
Ooh,
this is cool.
As cool as us.
So cool.
Cool, let's start the show.
Cool! This is not cool.
I'll get the old chairs.
Cool.
Hello, I'm John.
And I'm Brandon, and this is
The So-and-So Show. And as always, we are coming to you live.
We're not live.
We're coming to you pre-recorded from my basement.
That's right. And today we're gonna be...
Oh, sorry. I need to take this. Hello?
Could you...
Sorry. Yeah. Sorry, yes, I am listening.
All right, sorry about that. As I was saying, we're going to have a really great day. We're going to be
talking... What?
We're going to be talking at...
How much?
What we're going to be talking about today.
Okay, thank you for calling. Oh, no. Okay, what are we doing?
What was that about?
What?
What? I mean, we heard you. You sounded shocked and defeated, and then you started crying.
Yeah, I was just talking to my car mechanic.
Oh.
Yeah, my car's in the shop. It was making funny noises like rah, 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 and foobity-boop, 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 and we're running in the shadows.
I think the last one was the radio.
Anyway, my mechanic just called to tell me how much it was going to cost to fix it.
Yeah, fixing cars can be expensive.
Yeah, although $150,000 seems like a lot of money.
Yeah. What?
Oh, wait, this is him again.
No, wait.
I'll just... No. Hello? Yes? It is! Oh no! Why do you? I don't feel okay! It's not 150,000, now it's 250,000.
John, you don't have that kind of money.
But I need a car.
You could buy 25 cars for that amount of money. The guy is scamming you. How long have you known him?
As long as you've known him.
Me? Who is it? Hello, anybody home? Oh no, that's not
my mechanic. Yeah, it's Joel the Troll. My once arch nemesis and all around meanie who has changed his ways.
What's up, Master Cheese? I mean, customers. See? Loyal customers. Had to make a house call because somebody was too slow at answering their phone.
You called again?
Oh. See? Mm-hmm. Now, time for some more bad news. Looks like your conjugator is broken, so that's gonna set you back about another 100,000 G's.
Oh, no.
Conjugator. Mm-hmm. What does a conjugator do?
It conjugates. It sits in the engine next to the Flubbertron. Dude, this guy knows nothing about cars.
Yeah, Brendan, leave it to the experts.
All right, so what else is broken on John's car that costs $350,000 to fix?
What else? Wouldn't you like to know?
Yeah, I would.
Oh, well. His carbon baconator is all messed up.
Oh. Carbon baconator.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. And the manifold and the origami nominator is all just gunked up.
Oh, really? And?
And he also needs four of the round thingamabobs that make the car move.
Are you talking about tires?
I was using the technical term.
John, this guy is totally ripping you off. Yeah, none of these things are a part of a real car.
Well, hey, the rolly thingamabobs are.
Those are tires.
Joel, come on, man. I thought you got over being mean to people.
Hey, I'm not being mean. I'm being dishonest. Big difference.
So you admit it?
No. I mean, yeah, actually, a little bit.
Is there actually anything that needs to be fixed on my car?
I don't know how to fix a car. I can't even drive, legally.
Oh, okay. Well, thank you for being honest, but I believe I'm going to have to take my car somewhere else.
Oh, man. See what honesty gets you, kids?
Wow, okay. First of all, he wasn't being honest at all. He was lying to me this entire time. That's what dishonesty gets you.
I heard that!
And second, I just want to thank you, Brandon. If it wasn't for you, I would have spent $350,000 and be in debt up to my eyeballs.
Hey, that's what friends are for.
Oh, and what a better time to say, it's Bible story time with Kellen! I thought $350,000 was a lot for a dachshund.
Fellas, what's up?
Hey, Kellen. My car's in the shop.
Oh, sorry. Did the conjugator go bad? I'm just kidding. I saw the whole thing with Joel the Troll.
Good. You had me nervous for a second.
Yeah, me too. Hey, what do you have for us today?
Well, I know this may shock you, but I have a story from the Bible that I would love to share.
What? You? Give out.
I will not. However, it's one of those days where I'd really love your help telling it. Would you mind if I borrow your noggins?
Not at all!
All right, then it's time for a little human head puppet theater. So today's story can be found in the Old Testament in a book called 2 Kings. It's in chapter 5. The story begins with an army commander named Naaman. He had a painful skin disease, but he heard that there was a man in Israel named Elisha who could possibly help him with it. So Naaman set off for Israel.
Wow!
I'm not sure what's worse, the skin disease or the bumps on this road. Whoa, slow down, horsey, slow down. Slow down.
Once Naaman reached Israel, he found Elisha and told him about his skin disease.
Go, wash yourself in the Jordan River 7 times. Then your skin will be healed.
What? That's crazy talk. I'm not jumping in that stinky old river. No.
He did not want to do it at first, but Naaman's servants convinced him to listen to Elisha. And when Naaman finally jumped in the river,
well, here goes nothing. Cannonball! Whoa!
Something miraculous happened. After jumping in the Jordan 7 times, Naaman looked at his skin and he realized...
My skin! It's healed! Woo! Woo, 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 woo! Hey! My skin is healed!
So overjoyed, Naaman went back to thank Elisha.
What you said would happen? Happened! Now I know there's no God anywhere in the whole world except in Israel. So please, let me pay you.
I serve the Lord. You can be sure that he lives. And you can be sure that I won't accept a gift from you.
Please take it.
No.
Please.
No.
Please.
Again, absolutely not.
Okay.
Go in peace.
Okay. Guess I'll just take my money. I might just leave that there.
What is my boss, Elisha, thinking? Naaman wanted to give us a ton of money. I'm gonna get it back. You can bet your bottom dollar. Oh, my name isn't Gehazi.
So Gehazi took off down the road in the direction Naaman had left. He was so determined that he would get the money from Naaman any way he could.
Naaman, please. Hey, Naaman! Commander Naaman! Hey!
Whoa, horsey, whoa. Is everything all right?
No, I mean, yes. Oh. I mean, can I catch my breath for a second?
Sure.
Okay, so 2 young prophets are coming to stay with Elisha, and could you give me 75 pounds of silver after all?
75? I'll give you 150 pounds of silver. And I'll give you 2 sets of clothes as well. And maybe 2 of my offstage servants could help you carry all of that.
Thank you!
Well,
Cha-ching!
What was that?
Nothing.
When Gehazi got home with all of the stuff he got from Naaman, he quickly sent Naaman's servants away and hid all the money and the clothes in Elisha's house. However, nothing slipped by Elisha.
Gehazi, you are a sly one.
Gehazi!
Elisha.
Yes.
I almost didn't recognize you. You look different somehow.
Where have you been?
What? Wait, what do you mean? I didn't go anywhere.
Didn't my spirit go with you? I know that the man got down from his chariot to greet you. Is this the time to accept money or clothes? You and your children after you will have Naaman's skin disease forever.
And that's exactly what happened. Gehazi got greedy and couldn't understand why his boss, Elisha, didn't want any of Naaman's money. So he lied to Naaman and went against Elisha's wishes. But in the end, it did not turn out the way he wanted. What do you think, fellas?
Wow. That is a harsh story.
I hear you. Even though being dishonest might get you what you want, in the long run, it usually ends up hurting us and others.
Well then, I'm glad we set Joel the troll straight earlier.
Yeah, here's hoping he doesn't try to pull that kind of stuff on anyone else. Oh.
Sorry. It's my mechanic. I gotta take this. Hello? Uh-huh. $100,000?
Wait, Kellen,
it's Joel
not
the
real.
Troll.
It's not real.
He doesn't know what he's doing. No.
I got you guys again.
Man, you were good. You got me.
Yeah, I did. Okay. Until next time, I'll see you later.
See ya.
You know, Gehazi was willing to lie and scheme to get what he wanted.
Yeah, obviously not a trustworthy fella.
Yeah, hey, I think that has something to do with our question.
Oh, well then,
reveal the question. Why is it important for people to trust you?
Yeah, well, for one thing, I would like people to know they can count on me.
Yeah, when people trust me, they aren't afraid to ask me for help because they know I'll do what I say I'll do.
I like that. So what do you think? Talk about it together and see if you can come up with reasons why it is important that people trust you.
Yes, and until next time, I'm John.
I'm Brandon, and we'll see you next time on
The So-and-So Show!